Good day. I'm going to do another kind of control pour. I'm going to use a few different colors. I'm going to start again with blue for my sky. Except, being that it's going to be more of a summery sky, I'm going to use some deeper blues too. Not just the turquoise. And I might even pour a little bit of white in and lighten it up, but we'll see how it looks. Because until you actually do it, you don't know how it's going to turn out. So. Bit of the darker more towards the top, and I do think I'm going to mix just a little bit of white in just to give it a little bit of a lighter tone. I think this could dry pretty dark, but that's all right. I'll just mix a little bit in. It's probably all I need. By the time I smooth it around with a spatula, I'll have some different shades. Some white in a few different places and blow them so we kind of have some clouds, wispy clouds. Just a few, nice warm summer day, everything's growing beautifully. Need a lot of clouds, I just want a few. It's good enough. I like to make sure I wrap up my paint right away, so I'll need some of that again. Some colors I just mix up little bits of. A little bit of the darker mixed in, because this is going to be behind. And we might as well put a little bit down there, because it's going to be the grass anyway. I'm going to put a little bit of the darker in there just so we get some different darks. I maybe should spread that around a bit before I do that. I want to kind of get it spread in the canvas. It's going to be kind of the background again. The main bunch of trees. This needs a little bit of dark in there too. So you want to have darks to show the lights, if you think of it anything like other painting. If you don't have the darks, you don't show the lights, so you gotta kind of get them in there too. So let paint off of there. More of this dark down at the bottom here, so some of it off, because obviously I got way too much paint. Kind of trying to think how to do this. Some darker spots in there and try blowing them around, I guess. So we get some darker and some lighter. Probably should get some tree trunks in there too. But I got a feeling it might be better just to kind of scrub them in a bit. I need my brown. This brown is a mixture of runoffs, I guess you'd call it. Kind of cool the way how when you pull it through it kind of looks like it's some well, knots in the wood. I guess you'd call them. Kind of what it looks like. Painting with a, instead of a paintbrush. You're painting with a stick. It's the only difference. Like trees back in the distance. Hope you think so too. Some are going to be skinny, some are going to be fat, short, tall. Some a little bit bigger. Everyone must be settled a little. I always pull some grasses up, but if they're not settled in, they just look weird. Gotta go somewhere. There'll be a bottom somewhere. Roots. some roots down somewhere. Much for sorry, I'm losing myself again. Just because of my... just dreaming. I'm just figuring out what I want in there. Oh, this is going to look real cool. Okay. So now I'm going to take my finer stick. And just pulling the branches out. Make them disappear a little bit. Get some branches. And all I'm doing, gosh, see, I almost forget my arm is going to be in the way, but I'm just kind of pulling out a branch here and there with the point of the stick. I should actually wipe it off once in a while because it gets hung up with the green paint. Just scratch a few branches in. They'll kind of self, like I said, self-heal because the paint's wet. But it'll give the appearance or the feeling that the leaves are growing into something. Right? Because that's kind of what we want, is it? To appear like branches growing up. I said it, when it heals itself, it almost looks like a hint of a shadowing, so it's kind of cool. I don't know why, but I was dreaming this series, so that tells me I'm supposed to make it. So I am. Because there's a reason I'm supposed to paint it. I don't always know at the time, but it comes as you do. Now, I'm gonna blow it up a little because I feel like the paint maybe moved. Which is quite normal when you get this much paint on a canvas. And I'm going to scratch in a little bit of grass. It'll show up. It's the grass here and there. I'm just gonna scrape in. quit while I'm ahead because I think it's good this way. I think it's going to dry beautifully. I'm going to have faith. It is. So, I hope you like this video. It's fun trying different techniques in one painting. It's so cool. Please like, share, and subscribe. And thanks for watching.